मोर कहाँ आ रहा है?
ग्रीन साइड के ऊपर है,
हाँ
ये लास्ट में मोर आ रहा
है।
ये यहाँ पे है, ये डिसेबल पार्टिसिपेंट एंड एनोटेशन।
अच्छा,
ये कर लेंगे तो वो ये बंद कर देता है, तो बच्चा डिस्टर्बेंस क्रिएट करता है।
डिसेबल पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड, लेकिन उनके स्पीकर तो ऑन होने चाहिए
वो ऑन है, ये सिर्फ वो है
कि वो ना करें तंग ना करें। दो, एक आया है कोई, ये कौन है? सुबह थ्रेट, ठीक है। तो बार बार आ जाए, तंग करता रहेगा। सुबह तो मैं कुछ भी नहीं था, मैंने खुद टाइप किया। हाँ, तो थ्रेड कहाँ से है? इंटरनेट से। कायनात फुरकान, चार पांच ही हैं, फिर उनको समय तो आता कुछ नहीं, पहले नहीं आता। अठारह होते हैं तो ये तो चार ही हैं। ये क्या हो रही है? मेरी सांस की वो जो है उसके अंदर आ रही है। Thank you. चार मिनट ऊपर हो गया मेरे ख्याल है। हाँ पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं, ठीक है ठीक है, सही है। अस्सलाम वालेकुम, कैन यू हेयर मी नाउ? टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द प्रीवियस टॉपिक ऑफ इन्फेक्शंस इन प्रेगनेंसी। लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हेपेटाइटिस वी एंड डेंगी, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सॉरी लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टाइफाइड फीवर एंड डेंगी, बट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ हेपेटाइटिस वायरसेस। Now you all know that there are different types of hepatitis viruses in the environment. These are hepatitis A virus, which you are all well aware. This is spread. It spreads by the orofecal route. The other one is the hepatitis B virus, and this spreads through the infected blood and secretions, and through sexual contact. Similarly, hepatitis C virus also. It spreads by the infected fluids and blood, and by the drug users using the same syringe on different people. Hepatitis D virus is also by this route, and hepatitis E virus spreads by the orofecal route, but it's very dangerous and the mortality is very high if a pregnant patient acquires this infection during pregnancy. Hepatitis F is another entity, which is a mutant of hepatitis B virus, and then hepatitis G virus. Now, those which are of importance, or those which are common in our society, are hepatitis B virus. See, hepatitis B virus is a very notorious virus in the sense that its long-term presence in the body can lead to hepatocellular carcinoma and cirrhosis of the liver. And out of the total infections which are present in the society, about 50% are acquired by the babies during the in utero and from maternal to child transmission. See, and out of these, about 90% of the infected infants, they will become chronic carriers of hepatitis B virus. You can see the importance that it is only second after tobacco as a carcinogen, see, in the development of carcinoma. Now, if we look at the structure of the hepatitis B virus, it's a double-stranded DNA virus in the core particle. See, this is the surface, which is known as the surface antigen of the virus. And this one is the core antigen, which contains double-stranded DNA. The incubation period of this virus is long. It takes about few weeks to about 180 days. So it can be, the incubation period can extend up to 6 months or 180 days. Gee, any problem? Any problem? So, what are the clinical features? Most of the patients who are infected or they become pregnant with infection, they are asymptomatic. But if they develop acute infection, they may become symptomatic and they may become ectric, that is, they may develop jaundice. So it varies. They may or may not develop jaundice, and 50% we can say that they are usually asymptomatic when they enter into the pregnancy. Now, if we examine in the acute phase, the patient will complain of an urticarial rash all over the body. They can be arthralgias and psoriatic joint pains, myalgias. There would be hepatomegaly or right upper quadrant pain and tenderness. And jaundice may or may not be present and depends on the degree of destruction of the liver cells. So, how do we diagnose? The lab markers for the diagnosis of hepatitis B virus, these are the hepatitis B surface antigen, which shows that the patient is having a current infection. Or hepatitis B core antigen or hepatitis BE antigen, that is called. This is the marker of active replication of the virus. And these are the patients who are at increased risk for the transmission of hepatitis B virus to their offsprings or to the general population. And second important thing is the hepatitis B virus DNA load, viral load. If the load increases, the risk of transmission increases. If there is a patient's blood sample is taken and it contains anti-hepatitis B surface antigen, then this shows it's a marker of resolved infection. That is, the patient developed infection before, but now the infection has been resolved and the patient has developed immunity either after infection or after immunization. See? So surface antigen is a very important marker of the development of carrier state, because if it stays there longer than 6 months, it means that the patient is going to develop a carrier state. Similarly, if there is anti-hepatitis B E antibodies, like the core antibodies against the core antigen, then these are the patients who have low risk of transmitting the hepatitis B virus, because previously we said that if the hepatitis B core antigen is more, the load is more, then the patient is capable of transmitting the infection more easily. But if there are antibodies in the blood of the same individual against the hepatitis B core antigen, then these have low risk of transmitting the infection. Now, what is the impact on pregnancy? The patient can develop diabetes. The patient can deliver with low Apgar scores. The patient can go into preterm labor. Otherwise, in the general public, if the infection is not severe enough, it is not generally associated with adverse pregnancy outcomes. The pregnancy outcome also, it depends on the presence of the viral load and the active, and how much active is the infection present. Now, how does it transmit? The transmission is from any body fluid which is to which a person is exposed can transmit the infection. See? The virus-laden serum that is the most efficient mode of transmission. It transmits through the perinatal period. This is the primary node in Europe, in East Asia and Southeast Asian region, because the body fluid, the vaginal secretion, the fluid which are infected with the virus can be transmitted to the offspring and the baby can develop. Then there can be horizontal transmission in infancy and childhood. See, this is the primary mode in Africa, because close contact in the next years of life, or certain medical procedures which can be carried out, some patients, they contract the infection during their stay in the hospitals through the syringes, we can say, through the medical equipment which is being used, like anesthesia machines, then like sucker, if they are not properly changed, as the sucker tubes are not changed and they are infected already, then they can transmit the infection. Another mode of transmission is the sexual transmission, which is the primary mode of transmission in the United States. That is by saliva, vaginal secretions, and semen. Now, the parenteral spread is also the most common spread, like blood transfusions, like intra-IV drug users who use the drugs with, they get the drugs injected by the same syringe. So in this way, they can transmit the infections. Reuse of the disposable syringes, which is very common, and that is the major cause of hospital acquired infection in our hospitals. That is why the patients who go to the hospital, they have all the risk of developing hepatitis B infection. Blood transfusions, especially those blood which have not been screened for hepatitis B infection. So there is a vertical transmission as well from the mother to the child through the transplacental barrier. That can also occur. Now, if the transplacental barrier is good, then the risk of transfer is less, because it has been seen that viral DNA is rarely found in the amniotic fluid or cord blood. See, because the placenta acts as a very good barrier. But if the patient has developed acute hepatitis B virus infection in the third trimester, or if the maternal core antigen is high and there is a high viral load of hepatitis B virus DNA, or if a patient gives you a history of threatened preterm labor, it means that it's something to do with the uterine contractions and transfer of infection from the mother to the baby, or if there is hepatitis B virus presence in the placenta. So in a nutshell, we can say that the risk of vertical transmission is low until and unless the placental barrier is maintained, or if the mother is not having acute infection in the last trimester, the viral load is not very high, then the risk of transmission is only, it is during the parturition or the period of during the delivery of the baby. That is the time where infection can occur. So during the time of delivery, most of the neonatal infection is vertically transmitted by peripartum exposure. See, okay? Breastfeeding is usually not associated with transmission if the baby has been properly immunized by giving hepatitis B virus, vaccine and immunoglobulins. Otherwise, if the baby has not been vaccinated, immunoglobulins have not been given, then the breastfeeding should not be carried out. Another important infection which is common in our country is hepatitis C infection, for which we are very much worried because the rate of spread is alarmingly, it is increased. Hepatitis C virus is an RNA virus, and infection occurs at this by the same route through the infected blood products and injection of drugs. Mother and child transmission can occur due to contact with the infected maternal blood at the time of delivery. So with increasing the same parameters, with increasing viral load, the risk of transmission from the mother to the child increases. Now, what should we do if a patient is having hepatitis C infection? Now, in the European countries, the people do not usually recommend a routine screening of hepatitis C virus in pregnancy. But in our country, since we have increased number of cases, so we offer hepatitis C virus screening for every patient, for every pregnant patient. Although we cannot carry out interventions during pregnancy, but we must know the basic so that we can take precautions regarding the delivery of the baby. And the diagnosis is by anti-HCV antibodies, and we confirm this by the help of PCR or polymerase chain reaction. The long-term effects of hepatitis C virus are the same. These are the liver cirrhosis, hepatocellular carcinoma, and liver failure. These are the long-term sequelae and the long-term effects of. Now, what should be the mode of delivery? Elective cesarean section is usually not recommended. Why? Because the risk of transmission through the placenta is minimal, and we can avoid risk of transmission by avoiding certain precautions, like delivering the baby through intact membranes, with the membranes intact, and bag of membranes should be intact. Similarly, if we perform a vaginal delivery, there's not much of a difference between the spread of infection from the mother to the child, either we deliver by vaginal route or by abdominal route. So currently there is consensus that the babies, the mothers can deliver vaginally if we take precautions. Like, what are those precautions? We must not expose the fetus to scalp blood sampling, because wherever there is mixing of blood of the baby and the mother, the transmission of infection can occur. We should not perform rupture of membranes, and we should try to deliver the baby till the end. And when the baby is delivered, baby should be given immunoglobulin at birth, and hepatitis B vaccine should be carried out. There are three doses which are usually given to protect the baby. वन इज एट द टाइम ऑफ बर्थ, द अदर वन इज एट 6 months, 3 doses, सॉरी 3 months एंड देन एट 6 months. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट वायरस विच इज गेनिंग मोमेंटम इज द ह्यूमन इम्यूनो डिफिशियंसी वायरस और एच आई वी वायरस. दिस इज ऑल्सो एन आर एन ए वायरस. It is transmitted through sexual contact, blood and blood products, shared needles, when people are sharing the same needles among themselves. And vertical transmission does occur in the late third trimester during labor, delivery or breastfeeding. So all patients should be offered screening so that mother to child transmission can be reduced. And patient is initially, she's asymptomatic. But gradually what happens, there is compromise of the immune functions which leads to full-fledged AIDS. That is called acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So every pregnant woman should always be checked for human immunodeficiency virus in our setup also. And especially those who have received blood transfusion at a time when the screening was not available. See, so it can, because it can be transmitted through blood products. That is one factor. What are the risk factors for vertical transmission? If the maternal disease is advanced, mother is having advanced HIV infection or AIDS, then the viral load is definitely increased. So high maternal viral load is the factor for transmitting the infection. Similarly, low CD4 lymphocyte count. If the mother has got low CD4 lymphocyte counts, she has increased risk of transmitting the infection to the offspring. And if there is prolonged rupture of membranes, a patient develops chorioamnionitis, the preterm delivery and breastfeeding. All these things can contribute to the vertical transmission of infection from the mother to the baby. So a patient who's having HIV should preferably be delivered by cesarean section. But if the viral load is less than 50 copies per ml, then such a patient can have vaginal delivery. Otherwise, he is a candidate for elective cesarean section. And when the cesarean section is being carried out, the surgeon and the team, all of them should be properly wearing the personal protective equipment. Now, the management includes antiretroviral therapy in the antenatal period to the mother. And to the neonate, this should be continued for 4 to 6 weeks post-delivery because the baby can contract infection from the mother. The baby should be delivered by cesarean section, elective cesarean section. The breast food feeding should be avoided. It should not be carried out. But if the viral load is so low that it is less than 50 copies per ml, such patients can have vaginal delivery. And similarly, we can carry out later on antiretroviral therapy so that the baby and the mother can be protected. Now, this completes the infections in pregnancy. If you have any problem, and I want your suggestions that what should be discussed, because I think you people have completed most of your syllabus. So what would you like to do now? Any suggestions? Kuch suggestions dena chahenge aap log? Ek chota sa topic hai. I think that can be completed in the next lecture. And after that, I want your suggestions regarding what you want to do now. You want revision or you want repetition of any topic or what else. For this purpose, please open up your mics so that I come to know what you want. Ji Hamza, aap bataiye. Ha, Shamsa, are you there, all of you? Ya khali apna apne attendance lagai hui hai? Ha, जी बताइए. जी हमजा, यू वॉन्ट टू से समथिंग? Hamza, I want your opinion. You want to say something? Are you there? Shamsa? I think nobody is listening. Huh? Ahsan, would you like to say something? आप अपना अनम्यूट करेंगे? I want your suggestions for the next classes, please. You people are not interested, it seems. बताइए. मुझे ये बताएं, कैन यू हेयर माई वॉइस? और यू कैन?
यस मैम.
तो फिर बताओ आप नेक्स्ट क्या चाहते हो? मुझे आप लोगों की ओपिनियन, क्योंकि आपकी क्लासेस खत्म हो रही हैं सब. अब एक का टॉपिक रह गया, दैट आई विल फिनिश नेक्स्ट टाइम, एंड आई वांट यू पीपल टू टेल मी व्हाट टू डू नेक्स्ट. यू वांट डिस्कशन ऑफ द टॉपिक्स विद क्वेश्चंस? आई थिंक आई विल ब्रिंग सम क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू एंड वी कैन डिस्कस इट एट द टाइम ऑफ द क्लास, एंड फॉर दैट मैटर यू विल ऑल हैव टू पार्टिसिपेट. क्या कहते हो जी अनीब? अनीब आपका, आप बताओ. What do you want to say? जी बताइए. Any suggestions?
मैम
बताएं.
मैम क्लास से पहले ही सबसे मशवरा करके फिर बता देंगे.
अच्छा, ये कौन है? शमसा है? शमसा बोल रही है?
यस मैम. यस मैम.
अच्छा, तो अभी क्लास जो है वो, चलो ठीक है, मशवरा कर लो. डॉक्टर मलहात के साथ कैसे कर रहे हैं आप लोग? क्वेश्चंस कर रहे हैं या रिवीजन कैसे शुरू की है? चलो मशवरा कर. अच्छा चलो, आप मशवरा कर लो फिर बता देना कि कब आप लोग करना चाहते हो और किस किस तरह का आप रिवीजन करना चाहते हो, क्योंकि अभी आप लोगों के ज़्यादा क्लिनिकल क्लासेस जब शुरू होंगी तो फिर इंशाल्लाह हम कैरी आउट कर लेंगे. उसमें फिर रिवीजन भी हो जाएगी, उसमें आपके वार्ड टीचिंग भी हो जाएगी. अब जो करना चाहते हो, जो कुछ लेक्चर्स जो हमारे पास टाइम है 3-4 लेक्चर्स का, उसमें हम चाहते हैं कि टॉपिक वाइज रिवाइज कर लें. आपको हम MCQs दे दें, आपकी इम्तिहान की तैयारी भी हो जाएगी और फिर यह कि आप ठीक है. कुछ बोलो तो सही भाई आप लोग. बाकी सब सो गए हैं? अच्छा चले, फिर दैट वी कम टू द एंड ऑफ द क्लास. एनी क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग द प्रेजेंट क्लास? इट्स वेरी हार्ड ब्रेकिंग बिकॉज यू पीपल डोंट participate in the class the way you should be doing. So final year. So we end the class with this and we will do some other revision topic.